Hello YouTube, it's me Vipiano, and for today I'm going to show you something special. So I'm going to continue from my last video, learn how to play high life music piano workshop per se. So I've done part one, so this is part two. So if you check out the part one, I made an introduction to this groove where I play something. So that's what I played. And I also showed the left hand bass, where I showed the left hand bass. Oh, there's so many effects on this. Okay, so let me take it. So that's better. So where I showed some effects. So for today, I said I'm going to take it further to another realm, something like that. So let me play the old one, then see what we can add in now. Before you continue watching this video, please subscribe. I'm going to be using the key of F, and I'm using number patterns 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. Eventually, you can apply to any key of your choice. I showed you that last week, so for today I'm going to show you something different. So I'm going to show you something like this. Okay, 1 minute, let me increase the volume of my bass. So okay, so okay, so something like this. So this is more like a kind of vamping method on your right hand, and a kind of pause play bass line on your left hand. So my right hand, I'm just doing a... So I'm using chords. So the first chord is this 3 5 8. So this is a passing chord, which I have 3 5 flat 7. Then the third chord, I have 2 4 6 9. So let me start from the top. So the last chord is 2 4 7. So the movement is something like this. Now let's play with the loop and see how it sounds. Does is that it gives you the freedom to play. So to play anything you want to play on your left hand. Now on your left hand, I'm not going to give you a particular bass line on your left hand because I want it to be creative. But what do you have to do? When you play, there's a space. So in between those spaces, so if I do, so do, so go. So when I'm playing my right, I'm not playing my left. When I play my left, I'm not playing my right. Or I try to bounce when I'm playing on them. So I'm doing something like this. So let's take a simple progression on our left. So something like this. So this is 1 5 6 6. 1 5 6 6 6. Okay. Let's do 8 8. You can do 8 12 13 13 6. If I'm doing number pattern, it will be 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. Or we can do 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. We know our 8 is the same to it. 1, 9, 2, 10, 3, 11, 4, 12, 5, then 13, 6. Because why I stop at 13? Because the largest chord you have is our 13 chord. So I stop at 13. So you can still do, if you're counting from somewhere here, which is not here, you can still put it. So I do. So you can still say 1 or 8, depending on where you're viewing from. So I can view this. So. So you get it. So 8, 12, 13, 13, 6. Then that's the first one. The second one is 2 and 9, 9, 11, 9. Then you now have 11, 12, 12. 11, 12, 12, 5. So good. So each of them comes before each chord. I've given you the chord on your right hand. You can go back and check it out. So it's something like this. So good. So when one hand is playing, the other hand is not playing, it gives you that liberty. So if you can apply the first groove I've shown you in your workshop one, and apply this one, it's going to be cool. It makes your playing different. So you have to apply different grooves in your playing and, you know, makes it cool. So something like this. Let's apply this drum. Especially, this is very good when the singer is taking maybe a verse or something. You understand? So cool. So these two can apply for now, and I'm going to do something else. So this is more like a movement. I'm going to show you a movement. A movement to your five. Still in the groove. So this is it. So you have your 10, 8, 10, 8. You have your 9, 7. Then you have your, so you have your 8, 10, 8, 13. Then you have your 7, 12. You have your 6, 11. You have your 5, 5, 10. So you have your 4, 9. Then, so this is the chord that's going to replace your 5. You have your 2, 4, 7. 2 4 7. So you have 2 4 7. This places your 5 chord. So anywhere you want to go that has a 5, you can start. So it's more like a passing movement to your 5 during high life. And this applies to other high life groups, but particularly since you are treating this video, you're going to apply to this. So again. Get your 5. Now it's not compulsory you must start from here. You can just start from maybe, you know, it's how many movements? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 7 movements. You can start from the third one. You can start from 2, 3, 4. You can start from the four. Depending on the space you have. Because so you see what I did? Now, this doesn't mean you can also come back and go forward. So you can do something like this. You can go forward and backwards, forward and backwards, forward and backwards, forward and backwards, for you to explore your own creativity and use it in a way that is really, really going to fit you. So you can do that. Crazy. So that's how you apply this skill in this your high life groove. So I'm going to show you something crazy next time. I'm going to show you how to do some in between minor grooves or in between passing scale or chord grooves. So something like this. Try to add some solo. So I'm going to show you that in my next workshop, that's part three of this. So before I'm going to show you that, make sure you subscribe and follow me, like my video and drop a comment. Let me know how you've been applying the other one. And let me know if you have some issues. Don't forget that I offer private classes too, private piano lessons. And if you want this loop too, you can send me a message on WhatsApp to purchase it for a very cheap price. All right, I'm going to see you next time in my class. Take care.